弟兄姐妹平安。
Peace be with you, brothers and sisters.
今天是敬牧主日。
Today is a Pastor Sunday.
敬牧主日就是要纪念牧者他们怎样为主、为教会、为弟兄姐妹付出的努力和心血。
The Pastor Sunday is a day where we remember how the pastors have made efforts for the church, for the Lord, for the brothers and sisters.
就好像我们庆祝教师节一样。
It's just like how we celebrate the Teacher's Day.
虽然疫情的缘故，我们不能够聚集在一起。
Now, due to this pandemic, we can't gather physically.
但每个星期大家还是能够看到牧师和师母。
And yet, we are still able to see the pastor and also the pastor's wife every Sunday on the screen.
我们还是能够在线上一同敬拜上帝。
We're still able to worship God together through online service.
我们要带着感恩的心。
Let us give thanks to the Lord for this.
我们今天的崇拜是奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名。
The service today is in the name of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. 我们的主，我们的神，他是天上的大君王。
Our God, our Lord, is the King of all kings.
宇宙万有都要来到他面前俯伏敬拜他。
Every creature on the earth must come before him and bow down, worship him.
今天让我们也全人全心的来颂赞那万王之王、万主之主。
Today, let us also come before the throne of this King of all kings and Lord of all lords and pour out our feelings unto him and offer him our worship.
耶稣说
Our Lord Jesus said,
你们当学我的样式
You have to learn my example.
愿我们的一生都能够紧紧地跟随主
And I really pray that throughout our whole life, we will follow the Lord closely.
以基督的心为心
And let us have the heart of the Christ
以基督的爱为爱
And let us show the love of Christ
活出一个向主基督的生命见证
And live a living testimony that looks like our Lord Jesus Christ
深爱
们同心祷告。
Let us pray in one heart.
主耶稣。
Lord Jesus.
每次来到你的面前。
Every time when we come before you.
求你的宝血洁净我们的生命。
May your precious blood come and cleanse our life.
除去我们内心的污秽。
Remove all the filthiness in our heart.
让我们能够坦然无惧的来亲近你，来敬拜你。
So that we may come close to you to worship you with no fear.
求主帮助我们渴慕你的话语。
God help us to yearn after your word.
引导我们的生命。
Guide our life.
让我们紧紧跟随你的脚步。
So that we may follow your footstep closely.
活出你对我们的呼召。
And live out your calling.
成为一个合你心意的人。
And be a person that pleases you.
好让一切荣耀都归于你。
So that all glories may be unto you.
垂听我们的祷告。
Listen to our prayer.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
The scripture for today is taken from the book of Exodus, chapter 32, verse 21 to 29.
出埃及记三十二章二十一节至二十九节。
Exodus chapter 32, verse 21 to 29. He said to Aaron, "What did these people do to you that you led them into such great sin?" "Do not be angry, my Lord," Aaron answered. "You know how prone these people are to evil." They said to me, "Make us gods who will go before us. As for this fellow Moses, who brought us up out of Egypt, we don't know what has happened to him." So I told them, "Whoever has any gold jewelry, take it off." Then they gave me the gold, and I threw it into the fire, and out came this calf. Moses saw that the people were running wild, and that Aaron had let them get out of control and so become a laughingstock to their enemies. So he stood at the entrance to the camp and said, "Whoever is for the Lord, come to me." And all the Levites rallied to him. Then he said to them, "This is what the Lord, the God of Israel, says. Each man strap a sword to his side. Go back and forth through the camp from one end to the other, each killing his brother and friend and neighbor." The Levites did as Moses commanded. And that day, about 3,000 of the people died. Then Moses said, "You have been set apart to the Lord today. For you were against your own sons and brothers, and he has blessed you this day."
这是上帝的道。
This is a word of God. Thanks be to God.
感谢主上帝。我们同心祷告。
Let us pray in one heart.
主，我们今天要来聆听你的话语。
Lord, today we want to listen to your word.
求你拿掉我们一切的杂念。
Remove all our worries.
让你的话语能够进入到我们的心里面。
So that your word may enter our heart.
有你的圣灵指教我们明白。
May your Holy Spirit come and teach us so that we may understand.
赐我们力量能够活出来。
Grant us the strength to live out your word.
垂听我们祷告。
Listen to our prayer.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
今天是敬慕主日。
It is the Pastor Sunday today.
我们要来探讨有关领导的一些课题。
And so let us...Come and take a look at the topic of leadership.
今天我们要来看摩西和亚伦的领导。
Today, we're going to look at the leadership of Moses and Aaron.
上个星期我们看到他们在山下等摩西等到不耐烦了。
Last week, we talked about how the Israelites were waiting down, below the mountain very impatiently for Moses to come down.
就叫亚伦做一些神明给他们。
And so they asked and they urged Aaron to make them some gods.
亚伦就顺应百姓，造了一个金牛犊。
Obeying the crowds, Aaron made a calf out of jewelry, gold jewelry.
他们在山下就开始敬拜了。
And so the Israelites began their idol worship.
Oh, yeah. 一面吃喝玩乐开 party.
They threw a party and they were enjoying themselves to the fullest.
以色列人他们那么放肆拜偶像。
The Israelites, they were out of control and they were worshiping the idols.
会不会出事呢?
Now, would something wrong happen to them?
肯定出大事。
Definitely it would.
那时还在山上的摩西，他根本不知道山下发生什么事情。
Moses, that time, who was still up the mountain, he had no idea what was going down under the mountain.
但是无所不知的上帝，他看得一清二楚。
And yet our omniscient God, he knew everything.
他就吩咐摩西说。
And so he instructed Moses and said,
下去吧，因为你的百姓，就是你从埃及地领出来的，已经败坏了。 他们快快偏离了我所吩咐的道，为自己铸了一只牛犊，向他下拜献祭，说：以色列啊，这就是领你出埃及的神。
Then the Lord said to Moses, Go down, because your people, whom you brought up out of Egypt, have become corrupt. They have been quick to turn away from what I commanded them, and have made themselves an idol cast in the shape of a calf. They have bowed down to it, and sacrificed to it, and have said, These are your gods, Israel, who brought you up out of Egypt.
百姓的悖逆惹怒了上帝。
The rebellion of the people had angered the Lord.
一直以来上帝都说这些以色列百姓是我的百姓。
For in the past, the Lord had always said, These people, the Israelites, they are my people.
但现在上帝不要认这些以色列人是他的百姓了。
And yet we could see that in this time, in this instance, the Lord no longer wanted to acknowledge them as his own people.
他对摩西说这是你的百姓。
Instead, he said this to Moses, this is your people.
就好像一些父母。
Just like some parents.
他们看到孩子有很好的成就。
When they see that their children are doing well.
他们就很骄傲地说哇这是我的孩子。
They will say very proudly, oh, this is my son.
那如果看到那个孩子一直在做坏事做不好的事情
If a parent were to see that his son was doing something bad
那夫妻其中一方就会说
Then one of the parents would say
你看你的孩子又做了什么好事
Look at your son, what good thing has he done?
上帝现在不要认这些以色列百姓是他的百姓了
Now God didn't want to acknowledge the Israelites as his own people
因为他们自己造了一个偶像来拜
For they cast out an idol for themselves to worship.
还要称那个牛犊是上帝、啊、
They even called that gold calf as their God.
所以上帝的怒气已经来到顶点
And so God's anger had reached its maximum.
他继续的对摩西说
God continued to tell this to Moses.
我看这百姓真的应着景象的百姓你且由着我我要向他们发烈怒将他们灭绝使你的后裔成为大国
They are a stiff-necked people. Now leave me alone so that my anger may burn against them and that I may destroy them. Then I will make you into a great nation.
哇，上帝要把这些以色列人都消灭掉。
Wow, so now God wanted to destroy all the Israelites.
只留下摩西一家。
And he would only spare the family of Moses.
这是多么严重的惩罚。
What a serious punishment.
就好像当年他留下挪亚一家。
Just like how many years ago, he only spared the life of Noah and his family.
他把全地的人都灭掉。
And the rest of the people were destroyed.
因为拜偶像对上帝来说是极大的背叛和羞辱。
For idol worshipping was a great abomination and also a great insult to the Lord.
就好像两个人刚刚立下结婚的誓言。
Just like two people, they just made a vow of getting married.
说我们要永远相爱。
Saying that we are going to love each other forever.
我们永远要对彼此忠心。
For better, for worse, we're going to stay loyal for each other.
但是结婚不到两个月。
And yet, within 2 months of getting married,
我就发现其中一方出轨了。
Then one party actually had an affair.
如果是你的话，你会怎样？
If you were the one who is being cheated, what would you feel?
以色列的人，他们拜偶像就是在信仰上不忠。
When the Israelites worshipped the idols, they were now being unfaithful in their faith.
是信仰上的背叛。
They were actually betraying God in their faith.
因此我们在旧约常常都会看到上帝称那些拜偶像的以色列人为淫妇。
That's why we could see very often in the Old Testament, God called those people who often worship the idols as the adulterous women.
而且上帝对背叛他的人，他的惩罚是非常非常严厉的。
And to these people who had rebelled against God, God would send them very severe punishment.
弟兄姐妹
，Dear brothers and sisters,
我们要很认真地审查自己。
We really have to examine ourselves very carefully.
我们有在拜偶像吗
Am I worshipping any idols?
不管是我们一般认为的那些一尊一尊的偶像
Be the conventional idols that we normally see
或是像上个星期我说的我们自己造出来的金牛犊
Or like what I mentioned last week The gold calf that we cast out by ourselves
因为这是一个大罪
For this is a great sin
求主帮助我们不要掉入这个大罪之中。
May God help us not to fall into this great sin.
因为上帝是忌邪的神。
For our God is a jealous God.
他对拜偶像的子民，他的惩罚是严厉的。
He would only have severe punishment for his people who worship idols.
既然让上帝那么愤怒
，Since God was so angry，
以色列人的两个领袖摩西和亚伦，他们会怎么做呢
？Now， what had the two leaders of the Israelites done？
首先，我们来看亚伦的领导。
First of all， let us take a look at the leadership of Aaron。
亚伦，我们看经文，我们知道他是一个失败的例子。
By looking at the scripture， we know that Aaron himself was a failure。
他到底犯了什么错
？Now, he had shown us the wrong example by how.
他犯了第一个错，就是他要讨好百姓，不惜放弃上帝的命令而得罪上帝。
The very first mistake that Aaron made was he, in order to, to flatter the people, in order to please the people, he would rather disobey God.
我们要知道，亚伦当时就是他们几个人面对所有以色列几十万或几百万的这个群众。
So let's imagine this. During that time, Aaron he himself he had to face millions of the people.
就算扣掉一半的男人。
Now, if we are to divide the number and deduct half, take away half of the men,
至少都还有三十万。
At least there are still like a 300,000 men.
哇，那么多人。
So many people.
一人一把嘴。
Each of them would just use their lips to say something bad.
一人一滴口水就会把亚伦淹死了。
Even with just one saliva from each person, Aaron would be flooded.
可想而知，亚伦他所面对的压力是多么的大。
We could imagine how big, how great the stress that Aaron was facing that time.
而且一向来都有摩西在他前面替他挡着去面对那些百姓。
And usually there was always Moses to, you know, to stand between Aaron and the people. Moses was there to handle the people directly.
现在摩西不在。
But now Moses was not there.
他要自己第一次一个人去面对这些百姓。
For the very first time, Aaron he had to face the people himself directly.
自己要承受那么大的压力。
He had to bear such great pressure.
所以他胆怯了。
And so he gave in, and he was terrified.
然而这些都不是亚伦应就是顺应百姓的一个借口。
Now, this would not make excuses for him to please the people.
因为百姓的要求不是吃饭喝水的事情。
Because right now the people weren't asking for food or drinks.
他们的要求是直接顶撞上帝的第一条和第二条诫命。
The people were actually asking Aaron to violate the first and the second commandment of God.
而犯诫命的是死罪啊。
And by violating these commandments, you only have one consequence, which is death.
但亚伦竟然轻视十诫的后果。
And yet Aaron, he despised the consequences of violating the commandments.
就贸然造了一个金牛犊给百姓。
And so he cast out a gold calf for the people.
他宁愿顺从百姓。
He would rather obey and please the people.
他也不要顺从上帝。
And rather not obey God.
他宁愿听从百姓的话。
He would rather listen to the people.
他也不要听从上帝的诫命。
And not listen to the commandments of God.
胆敢得罪上帝
he just sinned against God like that
却不敢得罪这些百姓
even though he dared not to offend the people
结果就是犯下滔天大罪
in the end he actually made a great sin
亚伦今天的失败
now the failure that Aaron made
也是成为我们今天做领袖一个很重要的提醒
has become a great reminder to us all leaders
特别是教会的牧者
especially the church leaders
教会的执事们
the church pastors and also the church council members
教会的领小组长们
and the cell group leaders
我们在教会的侍奉
while we are serving at the church
是为了要讨好人还是要讨好神
we have to be clear of one thing are we trying to please the people or are we trying to please God
我们是否会因这一些人的喜好
now is it because of some people's preferences or some people's request
而去做一些得罪上帝的选择
we will make some choices that sin against God
教会是否为了吸引更多的人而选择向真理妥协
does the church give in to the truth just because we want to please more people
在教会里面制造一些宣称是上帝的金牛犊。
And then at the church itself, this the leaders they build God, they build gold calf and proclaim that this gold calf, this idol is God.
亚伦的第二个错误。
The second mistake that Aaron made.
就是当他遇到难题的时候，没有第一时间寻求上帝。
When he was faced with trouble, he failed to come to seek after the Lord's advice at the first moment.
而是依靠自己的聪明和能力。
He instead chose to rely on his own wisdom and also to rely on his own ability.
结果就搞出祸来了。
In the end, he made a great mistake.
摩西他每次在面对这百姓的抱怨的时候
Every time when Moses was faced with the grumble and the complaint from the people
他都是先求上帝的
He would first come to God
不管是那时过红海还是没有饭吃没有水喝
Be it that time when they wanted to cross the Red Sea or they had no food or drink
他都是先求问上帝该怎么做
Moses would always come before God first
上帝却指示摩西怎么做
And then Moses would instruct Moses what to do
如果亚伦他能够学像摩西一样
Had Aaron learned from Moses
跟那些百姓说等一下我先去寻求上帝
And told the people that please wait I would need to seek after the Lord first
那他就不会那么冲动
Then he would not be so impulsive
他也不会自作聪明去做一个称为上帝的经由度
Neither would he use his own intelligence to cast out something and call this gold calf as God
如果我们好好看经文
If we were to look at the Bible closely
亚伦不但没有第一时间寻求上帝
Not only Aaron didn't come to seek after the Lord at the first moment
其实到最后他都没有去找上帝
Even after the whole incident had passed he failed to come before God
这也反映出他对跟对上帝的这个信靠
This actually reflected how his trust in the Lord
他没有认清自己是谁
He neverAcknowledge he never saw clearly who he was.
他以为他有他自己有能力去带领百姓。
Aaron thought he was capable enough to lead the people.
他自己以为他能够用自己的方法去解决问题。
Aaron thought he was able to use his own methods to solve the problems.
却不知道一直以来是上帝赐给摩西力量，是上帝赐给摩西智慧去领导大家的。
Little did Aaron know that all these whiles it was God himself who gave Moses the power and also the wisdom to lead the people.
弟兄姐妹
Dear brothers and sisters,
亚伦面对问题的时候，他的选择。
When Aaron was faced with problems, he chose to.
其实不只是提醒我们这些做领袖的。
You know, the choices that he made not only remind us as leaders.
也是提醒我们每一个基督徒。
Actually, what Aaron did also acts as a reminder to all of us Christians.
遇到问题困难的时候。
Once we're faced with problems.
第一时间一定要先寻求上帝。
Let us come and seek the Lord at the very first moment.
不要靠着自己的聪明。
Do not rely on our own abilities.
很多时候我们都会觉得。
Many a time we would say that.
哎呀，我要先试一下看靠自己的能力看解决到没有。
Let me give it a try first. I'll see whether I can handle this.
如果搞不定嘛，哎呀，才找上帝。
If I really cannot handle this, okay, fine. I'll come to you, God.
但如果我们一开始就找上帝的话
，And yet, let me ask you, if we were to go and seek after the Lord the very first moment when we are faced with trouble,
可能事情就不会越弄越糟。
Perhaps things wouldn't get this bad.
可能那个情况就不会变得越来越严重。
Perhaps the situation would not get this serious.
因为我们第一时间找上帝的话
，When we come to the Lord first,
他就会赐给我们智慧去做正确的决定。
God will give us a wisdom to make the right choice.
引导我们去走正确的方向。
God will guide us to walk on the right direction.
求主帮助我们。
May God help us.
不管是在教会的服事
Be it we are serving at the church
在工作的问题
Or we are facing some problems at our workplace
在家里要处理家里的一些事情
Or you need to handle some issues of your family
我们都要第一时间去寻求上帝
Let us seek God first
这样我们就能够做最正确最妥善的决定
That way we'll be able to make out the best and also the most correct choice
也能够避免酿成大祸
and we're able to prevent big mistakes from happening
亚伦的第三个错误
and what about the third mistake that Aaron made
就是推卸责任
which is to shed away from his responsibility
当摩西质问亚伦的时候
when Moses asked Aaron what had happened
这百姓向你做了什么你竟使他们陷在大罪里
what did these people do to you that you led them in such great sin
亚伦怎么回答
How did Aaron answer?
亚伦说
Aaron said
不要那么生气
Oh, please don't get so angry, my lord
你都知道的
You know
这些百姓专门作恶的。
These people, they are so prone to evil.
整天都搞事情了。
They always create troubles.
动不动就发怨言。
You know, simply they would just grumble and complain.
动不动就讲要回去埃及。
They would simply say that they want to go back to Egypt.
甚至还要杀你和我，你知道的。
You know that they even threaten to kill you and me.
哦，因为你这样久没有回来。
And now because it took you so long up at the mountain.
他们说那个带领我们出埃及的摩西不懂怎样了。
They said that they do not know what has happened to this fellow Moses.
然后便叫我做一个神明给他们。
And so they asked me to make them some gods.
所以我就做了一个金牛犊咯。
And so I made a gold calf.
亚伦说什么？
What did Aaron say?
他说，他们凡有金环的可以摘下来，他们就给了我，我把金环扔在火里，这牛犊便出来了。
So I told them, whoever has any gold jewelry, take it off. Then they gave me the gold, and I threw it into the fire, and out came this calf.
亚伦说他把金丢下去火，那个金牛犊就自己出来了。
Aaron said that he just threw the gold jewelry into the fire, and out came the calf by itself.
这是什么烂借口？
What a lousy excuse that he was making.
是人都知道要做那个金牛犊一定是工匠精心设计的。
Of course, all of us know very clearly that if you want to cast out a gold calf, you need some carpenters, you need some skilled people to do it.
要做了一个模，然后镀上金，那个牛犊才是变成金，一个金的牛犊。
You have to first make a model, then only you need to plate it with gold, then only this thing will become a gold calf.
亚伦真的是当摩西是三岁小孩子。
Aaron really treated Moses as a three-year-old kid.
其实讲到尾。
Now, in the end,
他就是要说
what Aaron was trying to say was,
这一切都不关我的事。
This is none of my responsibility.
问题都是那些百姓。
All the troubles come from those people.
问题都是这只牛犊自己走出来的。
And the trouble comes from this gold calf who came out from the fire by itself.
推卸责任的领袖，相信我们都见不少。
I'm sure we have seen a lot of leaders who like to shirk their responsibilities.
特别是这个疫情。
Especially during this pandemic.
许多这抗疫失败的国家
，many countries who are who have failed in resisting this pandemic，
他们的政府或者官员都被人民要求叫他们下台辞职。
The government and the leaders were asked by their people to resign。
但有些真的是向人民坦诚哦，他们失败，然后他们辞职了。
Some they really admit their own you know their own wrongdoings and also their own incapabilities and they resign。
更多的是他们死不认错。
And yet many more leaders who just shirk their responsibilities and deny about their own fault.
眼睁睁看看着那个确诊的人数每一天都几万宗。
You just see with your own eyes that the numbers of the infected cases get few thousands every day.
还敢说他们现在的抗疫是非常成功的。
And yet those leaders will tell you that, hey, we are very successful in resisting this pandemic.
弟兄姐妹
Dear brothers and sisters,
身为领袖的
As leaders,
要坦诚自己的错误 是不容易的
It is not easy for us to confess our own faults
因为自己是站在高处
Because we are the one who's standing at the top of the place
可能他们生怕自己的地位不保
They are just afraid that their status or their identity would be shaken
担心自己的利益会受到亏损
They are worried that their benefits would be lost
担心自己下不了台很没有面子
they're worried that they're going to lose your face they're going to lose your dignity
这是一个推卸责任的领袖
this is a leader who shirks his own responsibility
他绝对不会得到他人的尊敬
and yet such a leader would never ever gain respect from others
更不会有人愿意去听从他
neither will anyone willing to listen to him
我们都知道人人都会犯错嘛。
We know very clearly that everyone makes mistakes.
如果一个领袖他愿意谦卑认错
If a leader is humble enough to confess his own mistakes,
其实他才会赢得人的尊敬。
Then only he can win the respect from the people.
特别我们身为领袖的
Especially we as leaders.
如果有犯错的地方
If we have made some mistakes,
求主真的是赐我们勇气
May God grant us courage.
能够坦诚的认错
to confess our own sins,
然后悔改改进
to repent and to improve ourselves.
这样才是一个好领导者的一个特质
Then, we will have the qualities of a good leader.
从金牛犊的事件
from this incident of gold calf,
我们看到亚伦他是一个失败的例子
we can see that Aaron was a failing example.
从事情开始到摩西向他追究
from the very beginning of the incident until when Moses came and asked him what happened,
他的言行举动都是失败的一个都表现出一个他是失败的领袖
Whatever things that Aaron did and whatever things that Aaron said just show us how bad and how failing this leader was.
因亚伦的失败也成为我们一个反面的教材
Well, I really hope that Aaron's failing example will also act as a reminder to all of us.
看完反面教材，我们要来看正面的教材
So after looking at the negative example, let us now look at the positive one.
我们要看摩西的领导。
Let us take a look at the leadership of Moses.
到底摩西有什么好的东西可以给我们学习的呢
？What are so good about Moses that we can learn from him?
首先，他的领导是以百姓的利益为先。
First of all, we can see that Moses always put the benefits of his people first.
上帝看见这些百姓拜偶像。
When God saw that these people were worshiping idols,
他就对摩西说：“我要灭绝这些以色列人。”
God told Moses that he wanted to destroy the Israelites.
然后使你摩西的后裔成为大国。
And make the descendants of Moses into great nations.
摩西听了有没有很高兴
？Upon hearing this, was Moses very happy?
Hallelujah! 感谢主。
Hallelujah! Praise the Lord.
哇，上帝啊，你早就应该这样做了。
Oh, God, you should have done so many, many years ago.
你都知道这帮百姓啊。
God, you knew these people.
死性不改。
They just never changed.
讲了又不听。
Even after so many advice.
整天在作怪。
They just continue to create troubles.
然后还要杀我。
And they even threatened to kill me.
骂我。
They scold me.
上帝终于替我伸冤了。
Finally, God, now you're doing the right thing for me.
感谢赞美。
Thank God, praise you, Lord.
摩西有没有这么做
Did Moses do that?
没有、欸、
No, he didn't.
即使他这样做也算合理、啊、
Even if he were to do something like that, I guess it was quite reasonable.
毕竟这些以色列人真的是没有话说。
Because I'm totally speechless when it comes to these Israelites.
如果这几个月你都有跟着我们一起来看这个出埃及记的话
，If you have been following us and looking at the book of Exodus for the past few months,
就知道这些以色列人真的是一般扶不上壁的烂泥、啊。
You can see that these Israelites they were really hopeless.
或者摩西可以说
，Perhaps Moses could say this.
啊，上帝，你要怎样惩罚他们就惩罚他们。
Oh God, do whatever you want to them.
因为他们罪有应得。
For they deserve all this punishment.
如果是这样的话
，If this was the case,
以色列人就会从此在历史上消失了。
Israelites would have been totally destroyed, vanished from the history.
我们今天看的就不是叫以色列人了。
Then today we're no longer looking at the story of the Israelites.
我们就是看到摩西人了。
We only see the Moses people.
可是摩西他没有落井下石。
And yet Moses, he didn't, cause troubles to the Israelites.
他也没有接受上帝要审判的。那个决定。
Neither did he accept the proposal of God.
他没有为了自己的利益而放弃这些百姓。
He didn't let the people go just because of his own benefit.
他立刻向上帝求情。
Instead, he immediately begged the Lord.
耶和华，你为什么向你的百姓发烈怒呢？这百姓是你用大力大能的手从埃及地领出来的。
Why should your anger burn against your people, whom you brought out of Egypt with great power and a mighty hand?
为什么使埃及人议论说他领他们出去是要降祸于他们，把他们杀在山中，将他们从地上除灭？求你转意，不发你的烈怒，后悔不降祸于你的百姓。求你纪念你仆人亚伯拉罕、以撒、以色列。你曾指着自己起誓说：“我必使你们的后裔像天上的星那样多，并且我所应许的这地必赐你们后裔，他们要永远承受为业。”
Why should the Egyptians say it was with evil intent that he brought them out to kill them in the mountains and to wipe them off the face of the earth? Turn from your fierce anger, relent, and do not bring disaster on your people. Remember your servants Abraham.Isaac and Israel, to whom you swore by your own self, I will make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky, and I will give your descendants all this land I promised them, and it will be their inheritance forever.
于是耶和华后悔， 不把所说的祸降于他的百姓。
Then the Lord relented and did not bring on his people the disaster he had threatened.
不但如此，
Not only so,
摩西还在三十二节这边讲到，
In chapter 32, Moses even said,
倘若你肯赦免他们的罪，不然求你从你所写的册上涂抹我的名。
But now please forgive their sin, but if not, then blot me out of the book you have written.
对摩西来说，
To Moses,
百姓现在得罪上帝。
Now the people had sinned against God.
最要紧的就是求上帝网开一面。
The most important thing is to ask God's forgiveness for them.
确保百姓不会被上帝灭掉。
In order to make sure that these people will not be wiped out by God.
即使付上自己最大的代价。
Even if he had to sacrifice himself.
就算是他从上帝生命册中涂抹他的名，都在所不惜。
Even God had to blot out his name from the book of God. He didn't care.
弟兄姐妹，
Dear brothers and sisters,
一个好的领袖，他是以他带所带领的这些人的利益为先。
A good leader always put the benefits of his followers first.
国家的领袖必须以国家和人民的利益为主的。
A nation leader has to always prioritize the benefits and also the welfare of the people.
教会的领袖必须以教会和弟兄姐妹的利益。
A church leader must always put the benefits and also the welfare of the church member first.
做老板的也是必须以公司和员工的这些利益为首的。
The same thing goes with the boss.
不然你的员工一个两个 take bomb 不漏，你的公司也是运作不下去。
Or else your employee would just resign and your company would not be able to run.
做一家之主也是必须以这个家和家里的成员的利益为首的。
As a leader of the family, you also must put the benefits of your family members first.
但如果一个领袖是为了自己的利益把它放在第一位的话，
If a leader were to prioritize his own benefits,
他就会变成一个滥权、腐败、自私、失败的领袖。
Then he would become a very bad leader who onlycares for his own benefits and he's a corrupted, he's an unrighteous leader.
让摩西却不是这样。
Moses was not like that.
他把这些百姓的这些生命放在第一位。
He put the lives of his people first.
恳求上帝放他们一马。
He begged the Lord to spare them.
拒绝了他自己的后裔成为大国。
He actually rejected the proposal of God to make his own descendants into a big nation.
第二个摩西要给我们学习的榜样，
The second example that we can learn from Moses,
就是他秉公执法，
is how he was very righteous in carrying out the law.
虽然上帝答应，他不会灭掉以色列人，
though God promised not to wipe the Israelites off the earth,
但摩西一下山后，他没有当着好像没有一回事发生一样。
When Moses came down the mountain, he didn't pretend as if nothing had happened.
因为那些百姓还是在那边吃喝玩乐拜偶像，
for the people were stillenjoying themselves and worshipping the idols.
摩西挨近营前就看见牛犊，又看见人跳舞，便发烈怒，把两块板扔在山下摔碎了。
When Moses approached the camp and saw the calf and the dancing, his anger burned and he threw the tablets out of his hands, breaking them to pieces at the foot of the mountain.
那两块法板是上帝亲手把律法写上去的。
The two tablets were actually God's handwritten commandments.
现在摩西把法板扔碎了。
Now Moses threw them and broke them to pieces.
不是因为摩西发怒，他控制不了自己的怒气，想要丢一些东西，结果就把法板丢下去。
It's not because Moses couldn't contain his own anger and he wanted to throw something and that's why he threw the tablets. No.
摩西把法板摔碎，代表着因为是以色列人他们违反了。毁掉了与上帝立的这个约。
The reason why Moses threw the two tablets was because the people, the Israelites, they had violated, they had broken the law.
就好像有些人他的另外一半对婚姻不忠。
Just like when your partner is unfaithful to your marriage.
气起来又把那个结婚证书撕裂了。
You get so angry you actually tear apart the marriage certificate.
因为那个誓约已经
Because the vow has been violated.
摩西不只是把法板摔碎，
Not only Moses threw the tablets and broke them into pieces.
又将他们所铸的牛犊用火焚烧，磨得粉碎， 撒在水面上，叫以色列人喝。
He took the calf the people had made and burned it in the fire. Then he ground it to powder, scattered it on the water, and made the Israelites drink it.
哇，看起来好像有点恶心和残忍。
Now this act seemed a little bit disgusting and very cruel.
不过这是当时象征着要毁灭一个偶像的。彻底毁灭一个偶像的一个仪式。
And yet, this was actually a common ritual that people did if they wanted to totally destroy an idol.
就是要百姓跟偶像撇的，他们的关系撇得一干二净。
In order to let the people separate very clearly from idols.
只问了亚伦的这个事情过后。
After Moses questioned Aaron.
然后就站在营中说，凡属耶和华的都到我这里来。
Whoever is for the Lord, come to me.
意思就是说，谁愿意悔改归向神的，都到我这里来。
What he was trying to say is, whoever is willing to repent and come back to the Lord, come to my side.
那就是还有三千那些不肯悔改的人。
There were still 3,000 people who weren't willing to repent.
摩西就毫不殉情的就把他们除掉了。
Without any mercy, Moses actually got rid of these 3,000 men.
上帝已经答应。不灭绝百姓了。
Now, God had promised not to destroy the people.
但不代表你还可以继续这样子做下去。
But it doesn't mean that you can continue to carry on with your sin.
就是还有一些死性不改的人。
There are still people who are stiff-necked and wouldn't change.
给了机会还不肯听。
They have been given a second chance and yet they refuse to take your advice.
所以摩西他不会再姑息他们。
And so Moses would not let them go again.
他便按照上帝的公义去面对，去对待他们。
And that's why he treated these people according to God's righteousness.
把那些原本就是死罪的人铲除了。
Now, at first, these people, they had to face God's death. Now, Moses got rid of them.
弟兄姐妹，
Dear brothers and sisters,
今天做领袖的也是会很容易犯下一个错误。
As leaders, it's very easy for us to make a mistake.
就是偏心。
Which is to play favoritism.
特别是看见那些跟我们比较熟悉的人，
especially when it comes to people who are closer to us，
或者看见那些跟我们很要好的人，他们犯错的时候，
or when we see people who are close to us, they make mistakes。
有时候我们可能会不忍心要责备他。
Sometimes it is, we just can't make it. We just can't scold them or punish them。
或者不好意思要讲他。
Or we feel too embarrassed to advise the person。
然后就选择睁一只眼闭一只眼。
And so we chose to open one eye and close the other。
如果我们这样做的话，
If we were to do so,
我们其实不是在帮他。
We are not helping that person at all.
其实我们是在害他。
We are instead causing him even bigger trouble.
因为他会继续犯错下去。
For that person would definitely continue to sin.
而我们也纵容他继续错下去。
And we're actually letting him, allowing him to keep on making the same mistake.
但摩西没有纵容百姓。
Moses didn't allow the people to do as they wish.
他要他们立刻彻底断绝这个偶像崇拜。
Moses wanted the people to immediately and on the spot to get rid of idol worship.
就是要他们不要继续错下去。
Because Moses didn't want them to keep on making the same mistake.
可能有些人会问一个问题。
Perhaps some people will ask.
为什么那个始作俑者亚伦他竟然没有事情呢？
Hey, what about the person who started all this, Aaron? How come he could get away from the punishment?
怎么那么不公平的？
Why is it so unfair?
是不是他是摩西的哥哥？
Was it because he's a brother of Moses?
是不是因为他是上帝指定的第一位大祭司？
Was it because he was the very first high priest that God appointed?
所以他就没有事情了。
That's why he was okay. That's why he could escape all this punishment.
他应该要死的。
He should have died.
为什么他没有被杀死呢？
How come he wasn't killed?
他亚伦没有事情，是因为摩西为他代求。
Now, Aaron was spared his life. It's because Moses begged for his life for him.
如果我们看生命记九章二十节，
If we were to look at Deuteronomy chapter 9 verse 20,
那边说到耶和华也向亚伦甚是发怒，要灭绝他。那时我就摩西又为亚伦祈祷。
And the Lord was angry enough with Aaron to destroy him. But at that time, I, Moses, prayed for Aaron too.
这也是我们要学习的第三个榜样。
This is also the third thing that we should learn from Moses.
领袖要有一颗 带祷的心。
A leader must have a heart that can pray for others.
出埃及记三十二章三十节。
Chapter 32 of Exodus, verse 30.
到了第二天，摩西对百姓说：“你们犯了大罪，我如今要上耶和华那里去，或者可以为你们赎罪。”
The next day, Moses said to the people, "You have committed a great sin, but now I will go up to the Lord. Perhaps I can make atonement for your sin."
虽然上帝已经赦免了以色列人
，Though God had forgiven the Israelites,
但他决定他不要跟以色列人同在了。
God decided not to be with the Israelites anymore.
他只是派他的使者去跟他们同行。
He only sent out his messengers to be with them now.
摩西还是继续向上帝求情。
Moses continued to plead the Lord.
上帝，如果你不亲自与我们同行的话，你就不要带我们进迦南地。
God, if you weren't to be with us yourself, then do not lead us into the land of Canaan.
上帝也因着摩西的代求，他愿意再次跟以色列人他们立约。
And because of the pleading of the Lord, of Moses, God was willing to make a commandment, a covenant, to make a covenant with the Israelites once again.
重新与他们同行。
Once again, the Lord walked with them.
身为教会的领袖，
as leaders of the church,
我们要学习常常为弟兄姐妹代求。
We must learn to always pray for our church members.
如果是犯错的弟兄姐妹，
if those that were brothers or sisters who have made mistakes,
我们更要为他们向上帝代求。
We even need to pray the more for them.
求上帝怜悯他们。
May God have mercy on them.
求上帝给他们机会回转。
May God give them a second chance to repent.
求上帝不要离弃他们。
May God do not forsake them.
我们不要小看自己的祷告。
Let us not look down on our prayer.
往往我们的祷告可能会让上帝改变心意。
Many a time, perhaps our prayer will make God change his heart.
就好像上帝因着摩西的祷告，他还是继续与以色列人同行。
Just like how, because of the prayers of Moses, God was willing to continue to walk with the Israelites.
他也没有杀死亚伦。
And neither did he kill Aaron.
一个失败的领袖，
a failing leader,
是为了讨好人而放弃上帝的原则。
Pleases the people and let go of God's principles.
一个失败的领袖，
a failing leader,
只想到要用自己的聪明来解决问题，
only think of using his own capabilities to solve problems.
却没有第一时间寻找上帝，
instead of seeking God at the very first moment.
一个失败的领袖，
a failing leader,
是推卸责任的领袖，
is someone who shirks his own responsibility.
相反的，
on the other hand,
一个好的领袖，
a good leader,
他是不以自己的利益为先，
doesn't put his own benefits first.
是以他所带领的人他们的利益为先，
instead, he prioritized the benefits of his followers.
一个好的领袖是秉公执法，
a good leader is someone who is righteous in carrying out the law.
绝不会偏心，
he will definitely not play favoritism.
一个好的领袖，
a good leader,
他会常常替他的百姓代求，
always prays for his people.
弟兄姐妹，
dear brothers and sisters,
盼望我们看见摩西和亚伦的这个领导。
I really hope that today, after we have looked at the leadership of Moses and Aaron,
也警戒我们不要学像亚伦这些失败的例子。
We would be reminded not to learn from Aaron.
也帮助我们要学习像摩西一样有好的领袖的这个榜样。
May God help us to all learn from Moses to have the qualities of good leaders.
不只是教会牧者还有领袖需要学习。
Not only the church leaders, the pastors need to learn from Moses.
每一个基督徒我们都需要学习。
Every Christian need to learn from him.
因为我们每一个人都会成为他人的领袖。
Because all of us will become a leader somehow or other to other people.
可能在你公司，你下面有你的下属。
Perhaps at your office you have a few subordinate under you.
在家里你有你的孩子。
At home you have your children following you.
这些你都是一个领袖来的。
All this will make you a leader.
我们祷告。
Let us pray.
主，我们感谢你的话语。
Lord Jesus, we thank you for your word.
让我们看见一个失败的例子和一个学习的好例子。
Your word shows us the wrong examples and also the good examples of leaders.
特别在做领袖的这个特质上。
Especially as a leader.
求你帮助我们，真的是不要以自己的利益为先。
Help us not to prioritize our own benefits.
但也不要去纵容那些百姓。
Help us not to allow the people to keep on making the same mistakes.
为了迎合他们而放弃主你的原则。
Let us not, in order to please the people, and let go of your principles.
主，我们知道我们需要，花时间去学习。
God, we know that we need time to learn.
但盼望有一天我们也能够成为和一个合你心意的一个领袖。
We pray that one day we will become a leader that pleases you.
走在正直的道路上。
Walk on the righteous path.
走在蒙你祝福的道路上。
We'll walk on the path that is being blessed by you.
能够带领你要我们带领的人。
So that we're able to lead the followers that you have given us.
能够一起讨你的喜悦。
Together we please you.
垂听我们祷告。
Listen to our prayer.
奉主耶稣基督的名。
In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
弟兄姐妹，
Dear brothers and sisters,
身为主的跟随者，
As followers of Christ,
我们都是他人的领袖。
We are actually leaders of others.
求主赐我们力量，
May God grant us strength,
能够活出主的爱，
To live out God's love,
活出主的怜悯，
To live out God's compassion,
来去对待身边的人，
And use God's example to treat others.
Thank you. 好，又来到一年一度的那个敬牧主日。愿接下来在牧师你的那个服事的道路当中，特别是过后服事的道路，或者宣教，或者接下来的生活当中，真的是求主一步一步的保守你。那我相信不简单了，特别是面对我们这一些有许许多多问题的又复杂的年轻人，然后甚至是一些面对着各种环境困扰的成年人都好，真的是我们都需要上帝的带领啊！当然我相信包括牧师也是，真的是愿上帝在你这个服事道路上面真的是有他大大美好的祝福，并且有他的美意和他的计划在这当中。
嗨，牧师平安。从2016开始你来到我们的教会，直到今天大概也有5-6年的时间，这几年当中你也很努力的牧养我们的教会，你在台上的正道讲得非常的精彩，非常的吸引人，内容也很丰富，再加上师母很准确的翻译，的确太棒了。除了正道以外，你也很努力的推动其他的事工，比如祷告会、查经班、团契小组、主路学、探访，还有社会关怀等等。整体来说你做得非常的棒，非常的好，我在这里要给你一个 thumbs up。
在这特别的日子里，感谢 Andrew 牧师一路来给我们的时间和教导，让我们能够活出神的爱，向万国做见证，非常感谢。
嗨，牧师，感谢你在这一年对教会的付出和对弟兄姐妹们的关怀，也很感激你在圣经的话语上对我们的教导，愿主看顾和赐福你和师母。
嗨，很高兴的是张牧师，每个星期天其实张牧师都很用心在讲道，我也得到了很多很好的基督徒道理。在这里祝福张牧师牧师节快乐。
谢谢 Andrew 牧师在我们难过的时候安慰我们的难过，为我们的难过祷告鼓励我们，然后也谢谢Andrew 牧师细心的教导圣经经文上的意思，神的话语让我们可以讲更加的亲近神。谢谢 Andrew 牧师的爱心，就是可以体谅我们的软弱，关心我们的苦处，陪同我们一起成长，就是这样啊。
Hello， 牧师师母，辛苦你们这几年在教会一直专心的服事，也一直为我们年轻人操心，也一直为教会里面每个弟兄姐妹们的属灵生命一直的去祷告，一直的去操心。希望上帝看到你们所做的一切，并且祝福你们。
感恩上帝安排牧师和师母来到丰收堂，谢谢你们两位的付出和一路的带领。在这个牧师节，我们要祝牧师和师母身体健康，天天喜乐，入也蒙恩，住也蒙恩。
Hi, Pastor Andrew, 牧师节蒙恩，我非常感谢上帝安排你来到我们的教会来牧养我们，非常的感恩，感谢牧师你所为我们付出的一切劳苦，愿神继续的祝福你和师母，天天蒙福蒙恩，使你们力上加力，恩上加恩。
Hello， 我亲爱的弟弟 Andrew 和永琪，我想透过这个敬牧主日向你们说一些话。每逢看见你们在台前服事的时候，心里总觉得你们俩是绝配，一个有讲道的恩赐，一个有翻译的恩赐，你们俩简直就是完美的配搭。也感谢你们为教会付出了你们的时间、你们的耐心、你们的爱心，愿神继续带领你们前面服事的道路，愿你们能够夫妻同心、同心合一的去服事，也愿神让你们能够恩上加恩、力上加力，能够为主做光做盐，继续为主发光，祝福你们。
谢谢牧师，常常用
上帝的话语来牧养我们，教导我们，特别在个人的这一个的生命栽培上，牧师也感谢牧师花了真的是非常多的耐心来帮助我引导我，特别是牧师也会给予很多这个的劝勉的话语以及适当的鼓励，帮助我使我的生命真的是在经历突破成长改变，真的谢谢牧师所付出的这一些的辛劳，都求神自己来纪念。
Happy Pastor Month! I would like to take this opportunity to thank all the pastors from worldwide, all the pastors from Lutheran Churches of Malaysia, and especially thanks and gratitude to my church pastor, Pastor Andrew Chong. Thank you so much for your guidance. Thank you for leading us and bringing God's words to us. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. Grateful to have you. Thank you, Pastor Andrew. And I also want to thank Kate, Pastor Andrew's wife, for being the interpreter in our church. Because being an English educated person, I definitely need an interpreter to interpret God's words from Pastor Andrew. Thank you so much.
感谢耶稣，谢谢 Pastor Andrew 有你的带领。
感谢耶稣，谢谢 Pastor Andrew 把神的话语带给我们。
Hello Pastor, thank you very much.
辛苦了。
谢谢你。张牧师，
谢谢牧师，牧师节蒙恩，
谢谢你 ，God bless you，
牧师节快乐，
谢谢你，张牧师，
谢谢你们，
谢谢张牧师。
让我们用主祷文来祷告。
Let us now pray the Lord's prayer.
我们在天上的父，愿人都尊你的名为圣，愿你的国降临，愿你的旨意行在地上，如同行在天上。我们日用的饮食，今日赐给我们，免我们的债，如同我们免了人的债，不叫我们遇见试探，救我们脱离凶恶，因为国度、权柄、荣耀，全是你的，直到永远。阿们。以下是一些报告及代祷的事项。
Now we have a few announcements and some prayer items.
首先
，First of all，
今天是教会一年一度的敬牧主日。
Today is a church annual Pastor Sunday.
我们都知道，做领袖的是站在属灵战场的最前线。
We know that all leaders are standing at the front line of spiritual battle.
时常都会面对到属灵的征战。
Leaders have to face spiritual warfare all the time.
请弟兄姐妹常常在祷告中纪念牧师和师母。
All brothers and sisters are urged to always remember Pastor and his wife in your prayer.
求主保守他们的心。
May God guard their heart.
加添他们所需要的一切力量。
Grant them strength.
这个星期弟兄姐妹还是可以带着感恩的心透过网上过账奉献给上帝。
This week, all brothers and sisters may continue to do your money offering with a thankful heart through online banking.
请你们注明好你们奉献的项目。
Kindly state clearly which item you're offering.
把收据发给教会的财政。
And send the bank statement to our church treasurer.
愿上帝赐福凡甘心乐意奉献的弟兄姐妹。
May God bless those brothers and sisters who offer willingly and cheerfully.
其他的报告请大家自行去看教会的周讯。
For other announcements, kindly refer to the church bulletin.
以下是一些代祷的事项。
Now we have a few prayer items.
首先我们为这疫情来祷告。
Let us pray for the pandemic.
我们感谢主。
We thank God.
在疫苗快速的接种之下，
As this vaccination have been planted very quickly,
让我国的疫情稍微有好转的情况。
We could see a slightly improvement of this situation in our country.
我们要继续祷告。
Let us continue to pray.
求主帮助我国很快的达到群体免疫。
May God help our country to reach herd immunity very soon.
让每个人的生活都能够再次的恢复正常。
So that all of us may get back to our normal life once again.
第二项。
Secondly,
为着弟兄姐妹祷告。
Let us pray for all the brothers and sisters.
眼看雪州的疫情逐渐好转。
As we see that the situation in Selangor is getting better.
可能在过几个月后，我们就可以恢复实体的聚会了。
Well, most probably we're able to get back to our physical service in a few months.
求主保守大家的心。
May God guard our heart.
让大家都渴慕回到上帝的家中来敬拜他。
Give us a yearning heart to come back to the Lord's house to worship Him.
回到主里的团契。
To come back to the fellowship of the Lord.
恢复服事的那颗心。
And to restore that heart and the passion to serve.
第三项。
Thirdly.
为着牧师和师母祷告。
Let us pray for the pastor and his wife.
感谢上帝。
We thank God.
牧师结婚了十一年。
After 11 years of marriage.
师母终于第一次怀孕了。
Finally, the pastor's wife got pregnant for the very first time.
求主看顾师母和胎儿都健康和平安。
May God bless pastor's wife, Sister Kate, and also the baby to be healthy.
也求主加添牧师有智慧去牧养教会。
May God grant wisdom to Pastor Andrew to lead the church.
继续忠心认真地宣讲主的道。
Help Reverend Andrew to continue to preach the Lord faithfully.
有敬畏主的心成为信徒的榜样。
And to have a God-fearing heart and to set a good role model for the members.
最后，让我们来领受上帝的赐福。
And now let us receive God's benediction.
May the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. 我愿主赐福于你，保护你。愿主用他面上的荣光照你，赐恩于你。愿主眷顾你，赐你平康。奉圣父、圣子、圣灵的名。阿门。